Hello and welcome to Saurav's classes. In this video, I am going to solve the question of 2012 DSE paper. We're starting with the question number 12. So what would happen to a confidence interval if you calculated 99% confidence interval rather than 95% confidence interval? So by 99% confidence interval, we mean that it is something like this, where the alpha is 1%. And for 95%, it will be something like this region. So the alpha is 5%. So obviously the confidence interval will be wider in this case. So the option number D is the correct answer. Now moving to question number. So in the question number 19, we can see the short run aggregate supply curve is upward sloping for which reason? The lower price level creates a wealth effect. The lower taxes motivate people to work more. The money wages do not immediately changes when the price level changes. And most business firms operate with long-term contracts for output but not labor. Now, generally in the case of business, generally by the economist like Keynes, and other new classicals, they actually admit the short-run stickiness of price. The short-run stickiness of price. And therefore, when the money wage increases and the price is constant, the real wage rises, and therefore as the real wage rises, it motivates the worker, to work more, and therefore shifts the aggregate supply curve. So the option C is the correct answer. The investor demand curve shifts rightward if the expected profit rate increases, the real interest rate falls, the savers increases their thriftiness, and the economy moves into recession. Now, when the real interest rate falls, it is movement along the investment curve. So it is not shift. Second, savers increases their thriftiness. When their thriftiness increases, savings increases, but we don't know whether the savings is actually getting translated into investment. So where can we saving investment gap? So translated into investment. So we don't know that. The economy moves into recession. That is actually generally lack of aggregate demand. So the investment cannot increase, but investment will fall. So surely when the expected profit rises, the investment demand curve will shift. So this is the correct answer. I hope all my previous videos regarding this 2012 paper and in this video will be helpful for you guys. I will be solving other papers in the for the DSE exams. Until next time, thank you.